Actually, that's a really good question. Why am I doing this? I'm doing it because I really want to step out of my comfort zone. I don't even friggin' go camping. So for a little gay boy from Sydney, this is a big deal. I have 1 week until I go into the jungle, and I'm not sure if I'm more nervous or more excited yet. But I am just thinking of all the amazing things that are going to happen while I'm in there, and not all the crazy things that are going to happen while I'm in there. So yeah, I'm just focusing on the positives. But I am really, really excited. I'm not sure if my career and kind of being in TV in the past has prepared me at all for this, because I think this is completely different to anything I've done. I'm actually really excited because I think, like, the shows that I've done in the past, it only shows a very small side of you and a part that the show wants to show of you. And I guess I'm excited for this because I'm not trying to push anything. I'm not trying to sell myself. I'm not trying to get people to believe that these song lyrics that I'm singing, I'm not trying to do any of these things. I'm just literally going to be in the jungle being me. And I guess people will either like me or they won't, but most of me, the Australian public, haven't met or seen before.
So people are focusing on, you know, what your lip fillers,
yeah.
Or, yeah, what, so carpets.
Oh, right, and these are from renowned medical journals like New Idea. Yeah.
So that must be annoying, obviously, it is, yes.
Oh yeah, it's a little bit annoying. It's just kind of like, I feel like the headlines are just constant.
For people that have never heard of me and they have a first impression of me on the show, I feel like they'll just see that I'm funny and stupid and goofy, and don't take myself too seriously. At least that's what I think of myself, so hopefully it's reality. I'm not too sure, I don't know how I'm gonna come across to the other celebrities. I can't like to think I'm pretty nice and chill and lovely to everyone, so I'm hoping that I won't have any dramas with anyone. But again, I've never been in a jungle for 3 weeks with people I don't know, so it's the first time for everything. My charity is for MS, and my dad has MS, and I think if it gets to that point of me kind of sitting there going, why the hell am I here? What am I doing? I think I'm going to revert to that. And even after just like starting singing and seeing that he was proud of me, and that gave me so much joy, but I've never been able to do anything really. But this has been incredible because that can be my charity. And when I thought of that, I was like, oh my God, it's kind of probably, it probably sounds a bit selfish, and it probably isn't in a way. But I think that'll definitely be something that I'll revert back to and go, okay, well, this is why I'm here. My mum knows about me going into the jungle. She's just like, I don't know how you're doing it, but good luck. She's like, I wouldn't do it. Yeah, my mum is a huge warrior. It's with good reason. I've given her enough reasons to worry in my life. But I think she's more proud than anything. And everyone can kind of see from a public way, my life has been strange from a young age, and it's been different. And my mum sees that, and I think she's really excited for this to happen, just in terms of like character building, and I'm really excited for that too. This is where you'll find me for the next 6 hours. I wouldn't want to spend 3 weeks stuck with someone that doesn't stop talking. I like a chat just like the next person, but when I need to just like switch off, I need to switch off. And someone that's a know-it-all, I can't handle it. I can't do that. So fingers crossed that neither of those people are in there. I do find myself sometimes in some confrontations. So I just feel like I've never been in this kind of setting. So like I can't pick it. Like I'm just not sure. But I'd like to think I'm going to stay quite passive throughout the whole time. Yeah. I can definitely see that I've been someone that's been in a peacekeeping role in like friendship circles in the past. So maybe that could be something that happens in the show, who knows? I get along with people like that are all ages. I used to work in aged care when I was younger and worked with a lot of older people. So maybe, even though I might run into someone that was, I worked in aged care with. I took care of a few famous old people. You never know. I'm really gonna miss my mum because I see her every day. I'm really gonna miss her. I'm in quarantine now and I already miss her. I'm really gonna miss my friends. I'm a very social person, and I get my energy a lot of the time from my friends and the people that I surround myself with, so I'm really gonna miss them. I think my mum's really, really gonna miss me. I think, yeah, she's gonna, we haven't spent that much time away from each other throughout my whole life. So I think it's, yeah, she's gonna miss me. Success in the jungle to me would be not saying I'm a celebrity, get me out of here, and doing all the challenges. I don't want to back down. I don't want to not do them. I mean, I know there's certain things that I'm probably just gonna freeze and I'm not gonna know how to tackle, but success to me is gonna be doing all the challenges and winning stars and winning whatever I have to win for us all to eat better food or however it works. Yeah, I just don't wanna back down. I don't wanna say no to any challenges. The first thing that I'll be desperate to do when I leave the jungle, there's a few things. I will want to get a facial because I get them 3 weeks already, so I will be dying for one of those. Get my hair done, give my mum a hug, and just sniff all of my essential oils when I get home.